I've made this amplifier quite a few times, and it's useful for voltages between 9 and 52 volts. 52 is somewhat too high, best is 48 or 45, and it's also in my book Schematics to Audio Amplifiers and Loudspeaker Boxes on page 20. And on page 20 you find this schematic. That is the whole circuit, in fact. But I made some changes and I will explain that. So, again, without that lamp. It can operate between 9 and 48 volts. It can give out, say, between 3 watt and 30 watt. And at the moment I'm testing this thing. And the adaptation that I made, that is here in the circuit. Between the two bases of the driver transistors, there must be a voltage drop of... That's enough to drive the end transistors out, both the driver and the end transistor. And here it's made variable with the help of, say, a kind of Zener mode of a bipolar transistor. And you can set with the help of that potentiometer the voltage drop between the two bases of the amplifier. And I made a change to make it more... to make the circuit easier by using here normal diodes, silicon diodes. When you want to use this amplifier, there's an important thing to tell. When you operate it, for instance, on 9 volts, you must set the bias, the working point of the complete amplifier, and that's done with the help of that potentiometer of 500K. You must measure between these two points half of the voltage, between X and A, half of the voltage. So when you operate it on 18 volts, you must measure there 9 volts. Another adaptation, I changed the value of this resistor, 2K5 is now 1K5. Anyway, the new schematic is here in this video. And the test that I'm doing now is a kind of thermal runaway test. And when you closely watch the schematic, you can see now in the middle of the screen these three diodes, silicon diodes, type number 1N4002 or 1N4007. It must be a silicon diode. That's the most important thing. And each silicon diode adds approximately 0.7 volts to that voltage drop between the two bases of the driver transistors. The good thing is that you don't have to align the quiescent current any longer, very precise. And such a potentiometer can always say age on the long term. And it can happen that such a potentiometer here ages so much that it doesn't function any longer and the amplifier takes a too high current and can destruct itself. Also here, when you have aligned half of the voltage, measure the potentiometer and then replace it by a fixed value resistor. Anyway, pin connections are here. So the test is here, a kind of thermal runaway test. I'm going to try, of course not real, to destruct this amplifier. See how it stands, how strong it is, how much heat it can endure. Before we see the effect that the supply current gets uncontrollable. And that's the first important thing when you do such a test. By the way, don't do this with your very expensive home amplifier that you bought for 400 euros or $500 or whatever. These kinds of tests can be destructive for an amplifier when it cannot handle the high current, and especially the temperature that is generated in such a test. At the moment, for instance, when I feel this, I can hardly touch it. I think it's approximately 80 degrees Celsius, 70. So that was important. See whether the supply current stays the same during the test. And here it's quite constant, 2 ampere, 30 volts. So we put in approximately 60 watt energy into this amplifier. The second part of this test is this. Remove the input signal here. And when it's good, you see the current fall down to a low value. And that's normal, because now the transistors are cooling down. And that makes that the quiescent currents also drops down. And when you wait till the transistors are at room temperature, you will see, for instance, in this case, that it is 100 milliampere or so. Perhaps 50, don't know that exactly, have to test that. And it's of course, the meter is too coarse. But anyway, and when the current falls down, when the transistors cool down, that's normal. And that's a good property. That has to happen. When the current does not fall down, when the signal isn't present, that's a problem, because the amplifier keeps taking current, keeps getting warm and more warm and hot, etc. And in this amplifier, like I told, there's no electronic circuit to prevent a thermal runaway. The only way that it is prevented here is the use of very sturdy transistors that can get quite hot or very hot without losing their good properties, without breaking down. And of course we know that every N-transistor, bipolar transistor by the way, has the so-called second breakdown. When we study how such a transistor works on higher voltages and on higher currents, and it even could be that when the voltage and current are not so high, the transistor breaks down due to the so-called second breakdown effect. Much more about that on the internet, absolutely sure. So that is, you can see now that the current has fallen down. I think it's approximately 150 milliampere or so. The voltage went up because there is no load. So let's do another test. Another test is to bring the frequency up. That's important. You can see here now that it is a good sine wave on 5 kilohertz, and I'm now going to drive up the frequency. And you can see that the amplifier starts to take a lot of current. 2.5 ampere, 2.8 ampere, perhaps. Now on 10.5 kilohertz, waveform is still pure. That's another way to test it. Send a square wave in. It's more destructive compared to a sine wave. 10.5. And now again, let's look at the current. whether it stays stable. You can also see the lamps don't light up so fierce on that higher frequency. That means, of course, that the amplification is less compared to the 5 kHz signal. But the transistors get hotter. There's more dissipation in the transistor. So it's for an amplifier as this, it's a more risky situation that it burns out itself. 3 ampere. Now we do we have 3 ampere at 28 volts, so approximately say 80 watts are now dissipated here inside these four transistors. That's quite a lot. And well, again the same test. Take the input signal out and look to the amperemeter. You can see that the quiescent current after this period of a very high frequency is higher compared to 5 kHz. But now it falls down again, and I'm sure, more or less sure, these are very, very rough tests. And I'm sure it will get back to a normal value again. Another test is to not send in a sine wave, but a square wave. Square wave has a lot of harmonics. 10.5 kHz. I now switch the generator to the square. We see the figure, the output signal change. And let's look again on the amperemeter. Well, this is quite destructive. Square wave on 10 kHz, 4 ampere at 24 volts, so approximately 100 watts. Are now sent into the amplifier and dissipated in here in the transistors. They get quite hot. By the way, not much hotter than they were anyway. And when you want to do the more or less absolute destruction, leave this situation for 5 hours or so. And after that, look whether the amplifier is still healthy. I'm not going to do that in this video, because in a normal situation this is an audio amplifier. It amplifies music or guitar, and this situation will never happen. Take again out the signal. Let's see. You can see that the quiescent currents now was quite high, more than 1 ampere, but it drops down while the transistors cool down. And of course you can go to more extremes. Let's go to a square wave of, well, that's not, it has a higher frequency. Luckily these transistors and transistors don't amplify very much in the, say, above 30 kHz or so. And back to the sine wave. And of course you can overdrive, you can give the also a way to test. We read now 4.5 ampere. I hope it will survive. I can smell the transistor, so I stop it, because I think this is not healthy. But anyway, I took the power out and it falls back to say current falls back. You can also overdrive the transistor with a 2 V audio signal. My camera is on 15 minutes, so perhaps it will suddenly stop. If it stops, then you know why it stops. This is what happens when you overdrive. Give the amplifier. Of course, you see distortion. 8 kHz, overdriven. So, also a way to do the rough test. And of course, after all, the amplifier must go back to the pure amplification of sine waves, music, guitar, etc., etc. And this amplifier does that. So it's a sturdy design. And I wish you luck.